Well, he's regarded as one of the greatest composers in the history of Western music, known for his orchestral concertos and vocal arrangements from the Baroque period. Oh, my heart just soars. We are, of course, talking about Johann Sebastian Bach, the German composer and musician from the 1700s.
And next month's Sydney Festival will pay homage to the classical musician, celebrating and deconstructing the great's work in a showcase called Temperament. That is Benjamin Skepper, who is the co-curator of Temperament, and we're lucky enough to say that he joins us now. Good morning, Benjamin. How are you going?
Good morning, Kathryn. I'm well, thanks. How are you?
Great. I'm really well, thank you. Firstly, I want to start with Bach and Baroque music. Why does it appeal to you? Why does it appeal to so many? We just heard Fauzi say her heart soars when she hears that music.
Absolutely. Bach is one of my favourite composers, but I also think that the music of the Baroque era has a very spiritual element, and Bach really, I think, spearheaded that. And, you know, focusing on Bach as an avant-gardist as well, it might seem strange 300 years on, but at the time, Bach's legacy, not only through their extensive composition, but also through their contribution to musical tuning systems, or what we call temperament in music theoretically, is now the prevalent system based on Pythagoras today and underpins the tuning of our orchestras, our ringtones, and even how music production software sounds. So
yeah,
it's actually quite incredible.
Who would have thought, right? And when we hear those two sounds, the very classical Baroque sound and then the sound that you're producing in Temperament at the Sydney Film Festival, how are you interpreting Bach for the audience? You know, how will audiences hear Bach? What are you trying to do with it?
Yeah, great question. Look, the program that we've curated really isn't a retrospective of Bach per se. It's featuring music of Bach all the way through to avant-garde and experimental electronic manifestations as well. So our real aim is to, you know, bring audiences into the world of Bach, but not literally. So we have Bach being performed by, you know, our classical ensembles all the way through to live painting, multisensory experiences and audiovisual experiences as well, which I'll be presenting as part of my program.
And we're seeing a bit of that right now on the screen. What is it that fascinates you about music and the external relationships that it fosters, just not with humanity, but with the environment and the external?
Absolutely. I mean, music is connective and it transcends the border and is healing. And my music particularly focuses on all of those things. And, you know, we're living in these really divisive times where we're constantly bombarded by crises. And I believe, you know, in the interconnectedness of music, and it brings us together. And my work is really about, you know, considering environment, the human experience, my field recordings practice as well, which captures sounds from all around the world. And I blend that in with my composition for piano and cello and create something that's quite modern in its context.
Very modern indeed. I mean, you are classically trained. So how did you come to this? How did you evolve into the artist that you are today?
Absolutely. The classical training is something I'm absolutely thankful for now. At the time, it was quite intensive, but
even the arpeggios?
All the arpeggios and the scales, which I'm sure you know about as well. But, you know, like I traveled a lot. Fortunately, my music has taken me all around the world. And by being exposed to cultures and other musical traditions as well, we talk of Bach and Western music as, you know, the dominant Western system. However, there are so many other systems of music and temperament around the world, which I've also been fortunate to expose myself to as well, which has certainly, you know, influenced my composition and the way that I approach my performance. And again, with the Prelude mi Fuga, which I'm performing for the Sydney Festival, that was premiered at the Moscow Conservatorium back in 2019. And even in a classical institution such as that, it was quite groundbreaking, for them to allow, you know, a composition so modern into the classical world. Mm.
You mentioned Prelude and Fugue there. You will be performing it at the festival. But what do you seek in your performances?
Really, you know, I would love my audiences, and not just for my particular showcase, but for all the performances, to come without expectation and just allow yourself to be immersed in the sound and the vision and the entire experience of what, you know, we're presenting you. I feel that music, you know, transcends language and gender and border and politics. And I think right now that's really critical in terms of, you know, creating experiences for people in summertime that, you know, uplift us and make us feel whole and happy and connected to each other again. Mm.
An uplifting, sensory, immersive experience, it sounds like, is coming our way to the Sydney Festival. Benjamin Skepper, great speaking with you this morning. Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks so much, Kathryn.